A pilot project for the implementation of the common code for the coffee-producing community. In the northwestern part of South America, we find a country, Colombia, is a tropical paradise, framed by two oceans and with three mountain ranges running through it. It has an abundant wealth of fauna and flora. Condors fly freely in its majestic mountains. Orchids are reborn with their incredible beauty, and it has a heritage of courageous people who have valiantly forged their own past, present, and future. Santander is a beautiful department in Colombia with a wide range of landscapes and climates where biodiversity, folklore, culture, and development all converge. It is especially characterized today by continual evolution, progress, and future-oriented projection. It is here that the Departmental Committee of Coffee Growers has brought together 33,000 coffee-producing families, all of whom are also members of the Colombian National Federation of Coffee Growers. At present, one of the committee's main policies is that of promoting sustainable coffee production and its commercialization both locally and internationally. The coffee grown in Santander is cultivated under shade trees of different species, thus creating secondary forests that provide nutrients to the soil, enriching it with diverse ecosystems and life forms. In general, wet processes are employed in coffee production. Clean water is used in depulping, fermentation, washing, and classification. Drying is done manually by taking advantage of the sunshine. The dedication of the coffee-growing families has resulted in a high-grade coffee which is produced under friendly environmental conditions and which is economically viable. It is important to note that Santander has been a pioneer in the implementation of sustainable coffee-growing practices and in the certification of its productive processes. Because of these things, the 4C pilot project for the adoption of the common code for the coffee-growing community has been put into effect in Santander. This project promotes environmentally friendly sustainability across the coffee-producing chain. It seeks to preserve natural resources over time, thereby producing a better quality of life for the community, as well as harvesting a high-quality product. The project for Colombia was co-financed by the Flemish government of Belgium. Efico, GTZ, the National Federation of Coffee Growers, and the Departmental Committee of Coffee Growers of Santander. Implementation of the Common Code for the Coffee-Producing Community in Colombia. Selection of the participating coffee producers. It was begun in the middle of September of 2006 with 410 coffee growers in 12 municipalities of Santander. Huespa, San Benito, Barbosa, Guadalupe, Suaita, Oiba, Socorro, Confines, Palmas del Socorro, and Valle de San José.
Para nosotros vincularnos a este proyecto 4C fue a través de los extensionistas del Comité de Cafeteros, que ellos muy activamente han trabajado por esta comunidad y han querido que toda la comunidad se beneficie, y al interés que nosotros también tenemos por mejorar en la caficultura, por aprender nuevas prácticas.
Estando yo en mi vereda, me enteré por los vecinos de este dicho programa del 4C. Saqué un día y fui a una reunión donde pues, nos dieron a conocer los extensionistas cuáles eran los puntos a seguir y cuáles eran los beneficios que iba a traer para nuestra comunidad.
Diagnosis. With the database of the coffee growers who participated in the project in hand, an initial diagnosis was carried out by technicians to determine the exact state of each coffee grower. Information was then compiled relevant to the implementation process.
La primera visita pues era para verificar cómo estaban nuestras fincas y leer arreglo que teníamos que hacer para poder nosotros seguir en este programa de 4C.
Training. The project has provided both hands-on training and training at a distance in technical topics, methodology, group management, and motivation, among other things. This training guarantees that coffee growing processes are of optimum quality and are able to obtain favorable results. Practical, concrete, and substantive training has been applied to the diverse needs of Colombian coffee growers. Likewise, topics that were covered included quality coffee, first aid, fire control, leadership, flora and fauna conservation, handling of solid waste materials, children's rights and labor contracting, among others. The enthusiasm and the commitment of the coffee growers has resulted in record attendance levels.
Una vez dentro del grupo, pues seguí asistiendo a las capacitaciones que nos daban los extensionistas. Entre esas estaba el manejo de basuras en la finca, estaba la capacitación del tratamiento de aguas residuales de la misma, el trato de los obreros. Y así sucesivamente fueron muchas las cosas que me llamaron la atención.
Las capacitaciones hemos visto la importancia que es cuidar el medio ambiente para nosotros. Nosotros evitamos las quemas, las talas de árboles, para que nuestro recurso hídrico pues nos acabe.
Analysis of the documentation for its implementation. The proper indicators for Colombian coffee growers were adopted in accordance with the Common Code for the Colombian Coffee Growing Community. The 4C Association provided the documentation for this. This permitted the design of tools to ensure the application of sustainable practices for small coffee growers. Taking into account Colombia's real situation and its national policies, especially those of the Coffee Growers Federation, the 4C standards provide a favorable tool for the application of the norms, generating verifiable results.
Dentro del proceso de aplicación del proyecto, se desarrollaron materiales educativos de fácil entendimiento por parte de los caficultores, logrando un entendimiento de las diferentes áreas que conforman el código.
Self-evaluation and results. Based on the 4C code indicators, an individual self-evaluation was developed. This document allowed an analysis of each coffee grower in relation to the requirements of the code. Based on the results obtained, a concrete plan was outlined to guarantee that each producer achieve a yellow average.
Primero nos hicieron una autoevaluación en la finca, o sea, qué nos hacía falta, para qué teníamos que hacer, qué cambios teníamos que realizar. Debido a eso, pues se nos encomendaron unas tareas, obviamente, en cuanto a que, por ejemplo, para tratar las aguas con trapagrasas, las aguas de la cocina y demás, que hacer el pozo séptico.
Nos evalúan a través del sistema semáforo para conocer el estado real de la finca. Un rojo era malo para nosotros, un amarillo era bueno y un verde excelente. Nos hicieron la autoevaluación y nos pudimos dar cuenta en qué estábamos fallando. Cuando tenemos la evaluación, hacemos un plan de mejoras continuas dentro de nuestras fincas.
Verification. In the middle of October, the company Biotrópico carried out a verification process on 10 farms chosen at random to ensure that the code was being properly implemented. Results were highly favorable, and the coffee growers deeply committed and motivated to continue the 4C process.
Vino la verificación de las tareas que se nos habían dejado por parte de los extensionistas del comité y las personas encargadas del proyecto 4C, del programa 4C, en vista que cumplimos con esas tareas encomendadas, fue como pues ahí sí se nos entregó el diploma.
Licensing. On November 29th of 2007, Flemish government representatives from Belgium visited Santander and met with 100 coffee growers participating in the project to discuss experiences and knowledge acquired in the first phase of the 4C code. Likewise, the sponsors licensed 387 coffee growers to sell their coffee under the 4C denomination.
Mi mayor orgullo en la auditoría fue saber que fui la segunda persona visitada y ver que todo lo que ellos venían a ver se encontraba en perfectas condiciones.
Esta fue la licencia obtenida en noviembre del año pasado y a partir de ahí iniciamos a vender el café 4C.
An analysis of the program dimensions. The social dimension. Children's rights and their education, favorable working conditions, and skills development form the basis of the social dimension. Colombia is a country that meets the requirements of the Common Code, which are protected by national law.
El año pasado terminé bachillerato. Pienso terminar el ciclo y luego de que termine acá trabajar. Para darme una carrera que siempre me ha gustado o licenciarme en matemáticas que también me gusta.
En mi futuro espero que al igual que mi niñez sea en el campo, para ser un transformador del campo y para que desde el campo podamos ayudar a las personas de otras naciones.
En cuanto a lo social también hemos aprendido muchas cosas importantes como es las buenas relaciones con la comunidad. Empezando por la familia, porque la familia es la base fundamental de la sociedad.
The environmental dimension. Biodiversity in flora and fauna, the correct use of agricultural chemicals, water management and protection, waste material disposal, and the promotion of renewable energy form the basis for the environmental dimension of the program.
A ver, nosotros como jóvenes podemos empezar porque tenemos derecho y somos capaces de instruir acá a estos niños que están pequeñitos aún y que sean conscientes de cuidar el medio ambiente, todo lo que nos rodea que es nuestra vida en sí.
Mi compromiso con el medio ambiente es evitar botar basuras, hablarle a la gente que no deben quemar, empezar por estos niños como proyección de docencia que tengo, son niños del futuro y a ellos también se les puede ir enseñando para que le vayan enseñando también a los padres.
The economic dimension. Information related to marketing, product quality, commercialization, and the supply chain are the basis of the economic dimension. In this area, our country is strong, as work that has been done over time has allowed for the constant development. It can be justifiably concluded that the common code for the coffee-growing community in Colombia is fertile ground for its application.